Hey guys, welcome to the next episode of Celeb Talk. Today I have with me a very special guest, Sanjana Galrani. She's a woman who doesn't hesitate to take on different roles. She enjoys aerobics, fitness, cycling, badminton and whatnot. Let's meet the power woman, a woman who has her own power yoga academy as well. Welcome to our show, Sanjana. Hi. Glad to have you on the show.
Hi.
So what's been happening?
I think there's a lot of work which has always been happening. I started the year with a new release which was titled Mandya to Mumbai. It has always been very eventful when it comes to me and my life, and I'm very happy that it is this way, because for me life has to be about working, as I come across as an extremely workaholic person. And I'm working on multiple projects right now, from currently working on a couple of brands as their brand ambassador to, start. I just laid my foundation with a new company for CCTV cameras, and in fact, the last New Year night, the entire MG Road kiosk was covered by my company titled Sterling CCTV cameras. If you could discover, I was all over the roads with the hoardings on MG Road and Brigade Road. So Sterling CCTV cameras is one company that is functioning right now and will function always. And then I have Akshar Power Yoga Academy, exclusively the Kormangla branch is where my team functions out of. Apart from that, it has been films. I have this film titled Happy Birthday in Telugu. I have this wonderful film, and right now while we are talking today, the audio of my Malayalam film has just released about 2 days ago, titled Janath, and the song which has me and my co-star Mr. Amir Niaz in it. I think it's super trending in the whole of Mollywood, and I'm really excited. And in Kannada, Namma Karnataka Dalli, Dandupalya Part 2 Kelsa Nadita Ide. And Namma Khushiya Vishaya Yenagide Andre, Dandupalya Part 2 Nalli Kelsa Madoru, Dandupalya Part 3 Allu Namma Payana Continue Agutte. Hagagi Dandupalya Part 2 is what I will be immediately seen in. I think by March is when it should release, or April at the most. Followed by, I think, towards the year end, I'll have Dandupalya Part 3 releasing.
Super. So, quite a journey you've had, 2006 to 2017. Wow. What is the highlight of this entire journey for you?
I think every day is a highlight. I think signing Sardar Gabbar Singh with Pawan Kalyan sir, that was a big highlight. Signing Bujjigadu with Prabhas, the Bahubali Prabhas, and working under Puri Jagannath sir's direction was a big highlight. Working on the most sensational debut in the history of Kannada industry, Ganda Hendithi, was a highlight. And then working with Mohanlal sir was a highlight. Working with Mamuti sir was a highlight. Working with Darshan here was a highlight. Working with Shivraj Kumar sir was a highlight. I think I have quite a few highlighted streaks by now. Just not one highlight. And all these people have been great co-stars, and it has been a wonderful journey working with the established achievers in my life.
And you've actually picked up quite a few awards, isn't it?
Yeah, it's very important. I think I always say that to the organizers who organize award functions, that yes, it's you who actually motivate the spirit into the existence of all actors and actresses, and boost them to even do better in life. So yes, a couple of awards, like the most prestigious of all was, of course, the world class Limca Book of World Records is when I made my space there.
Right. And also you won the Bangalore Times Award, Filmfare Award.
Correct, yes. That was for Matte Bani Preet Sona, yes.
You are not less than a social media queen. You use social media to your benefit big time. So you really think that helps you connect with your audiences?
I want to stay connected with my audience. Today, if I'm a star, it's because people have made me a star. I'm not a star because I'm a self-acclaimed star. So you can follow those numbers. My Facebook page has about 23 lakh followers, and it's each one of them that has made me so precious, or rather it's going towards 24 lakh people, and including Instagram and including Twitter, I think I have another 3 lakh there. So about 26 or 27 lakh people who look forward to what I'm doing, and I think just giving them a small jiffy about what my life looks like, even personally is a great thing, because when my film releases, it's these people who go and watch the films and they applaud it or they criticize it depending on the quality of the film, but nevertheless these are the guys who make me what I am today.
Yes, they can make or break a movie or a star, the audience. How good are you at taking criticism? Do you think it actually is constructive?
I take it very, very constructively. Firstly, I understand the root cause of the criticism. Am I wrong or is the opposite person wrong? But gone are those days when I used to not take it very well. I think whenever I ask somebody, how did you like my film? I wouldn't ask them, what is the best thing in the film? I'll be like, tell me what was the worst thing in the film? Which was the worst scene of mine? Why didn't you like it? Because I want to improvise each time. And then later on, I want them to seep into talking about the good things, and I don't want to like look forward to applause from somebody. So that every day I evolve to a better tomorrow.
Right. And considering that you're so, you speak your mind, so you are not like other stars who say something and do something. You think that went against you?
Not at all. I think that worked for me, because when people talk to me, or you know, I have earned very few people in my life who are my best friends, or who are people whom I work with. My work people are not my best friends at all. They're just my work people, they're just my work associates or my work colleagues respectively. But I think I have a few people who are real people who really stay close to my heart, and I do not bother in convincing people who do not like me. I don't think that's my cup of tea at all. Yeah.
Right. So the role of your family, did they ever think that their daughter would be a star like this? And how was there any resistance at all at any stage?
I come from a middle class family, so back then when I was trying to get into the films, like, I don't hesitate in saying it out anywhere that I come in from a middle class family, but yeah, by God's grace I've done really well for myself, and I'm still craving to do better and better every day. But yeah, my mum's a very simple, bubbly, middle class woman who's very happy that she has two stars at home, and my dad is just there's a happy bhagban going on in my house where my mum's with me in the location, my dad is with my sister, or my dad's with me and my mum's with her. So there's a happy bhagban, not a sad bhagban going on. But yeah, I think we enjoy it, and it's more like I take care of my mum and dad now. It's pretty much like that. I'm like the parent at home or something like that, because of the work experience I have and because of how life has made me evolve.
Right, talking about evolution, let me tell you, she was a model. She started out at a very young age, not even your 20s.
I started out in life while I was about 12.
Oops.
Yeah, so I was like a child artist. I've worked in two or three films as a child artist. And today when suddenly people see it, then I get a sudden tweet, "Is that you, ma'am? That looks like a baby version of you." So they, people can't even relate to that person and me right now where I'm standing today.
All right, great. So when you make a choice of roles, mm-hmm. right, what are you looking at? Are you consciously making an effort to, go for a role which is you've never done before? Is that how you make choices of movies?
I look at a very dignified team at the first place. I look at great dignity in the producer. I look at great professionalism in the director. I look at how efficiently they can release the film. And if I think they are very efficient, only then would I even proceed to listening to the script. And then I'll of course listen to the script, I'll hear out my character, and if everything works out, then I sign the film. But it takes a lot for me to sign a film today. Mm-hmm. I wouldn't sign any or every run-of-the-mill film at all.
So Sanjana Dandupalya 2, did you have a role model that you followed, or what kind of work went into doing that role, preparing for that role?
You have to study, you have to Wikipedia these Dandupalya people, and because of this team Dandupalya, the entire village of Dandupalya's name is spoiled forever in the history of India, or in the history of the world for that reason. So these are extremely cold-blooded murderers, and then when you go and meet them in the central jails out there located close to Dandupalya, they have nothing to say. They still just say they're innocent, and they have like red blood in their eyes. Meeting them itself is experience. Mm-hmm. Like, you'll have a shiver going up your spine, and then they'll just behave so innocent. They'll be like, "No, we just tapped."
Right.
Wow, it's like you really feel really, really afraid to be even doing a film like that. You get jitters in the night when you mm-hmm. sleep. But I think that's what my job is all about.
All right. So, what is your role in that movie?
It's a cold-blooded murderer. That is something I can definitely disclose right now.
Okay.
So the rest of the things, I think I will probably, you'll have to wait and watch.
So are you waiting for some dream role, Sanjana?
I think, yeah, for an artist, you know how it is. You're just as good as your last film. So I want to do a role like what Shah Rukh Khan did in A Kal Ho Na Ho, where he's a lover and still a sacrificer and still a great friend and still a great boyfriend. And it had all the shades. So, you know, maybe something like that would really excite me, and something extremely performance oriented. And these days I feel very responsible as an activist. I've gotten so much success and recognition from the society. So that was the main reason that I started off my own power yoga center. Like, I had a lot of friends coming and telling me, let's invest in a pub, let's invest in a restaurant, let's invest in alcohol and, you know, whatnot. But then when Akshar ji came and told me that people like you, Sanjana, should have your own yoga academy, I was like, wow, great. Yeah, I think that sounds good, because I want people to be in great health because of me. And I want to give them great health and peace of mind and happiness. So what better way than getting them enrolled into a yoga academy? And so many students who have come to my academy, I probably don't even charge them for a couple of days, because I want them to get a hang of what they want to do. And I gift it to them from my side, because, you know, students just live on pocket money, right? So if they come into like premier yoga academies like mine, then they suddenly feel, oh my God, okay, this is really going to cut our pockets off, and they'll have no money left for themselves. But it's okay. I'm there for all of you, and you can definitely come to my academy, and I can offer you a couple of complimentary sessions, all of you, anyone or everyone who's watching this video, from a small baby to an adult.
So is that why you took up this show on TV regarding kabaddi?
No, kabaddi is this is entertainment, you know, and this is the most successful, you know, highest TRP based channel, Udaya TV, and it has this kick-ass show, and this has a wonderful director who knows what he's doing, and he just knows exactly what the audience want.
So do you have a favorite actor or actress?
I have a couple of them, actually. The list is quite long, so if I'm probably taking everybody's name, they'll think I'm pleasing them. So I don't want to get into that.
So what's happening next for you?
Next, I think it's releases and it's work, and then it's regular, like I'm like on a run always. I wake up in the morning, I finish my phone calls, and if I have shooting, then it's like meditation. I feel so much at peace, I feel so much at calm and happiness. And I have very less work if I have shooting, is what I have to say, because I keep my phones at bay when I'm shooting. But when I'm not shooting, it's a havoc. Like, I have like, I think 100, 150 calls to take and to make things happen, and etc. and etc. And now with two companies in my hand, my CCTV camera company and Akshar Power Yoga, and then firms, and then listening to new scripts and award functions and inaugurations and appearances and friends and family. I think there's a lot to do in life.
So, very important question. Is Sanjana settling down sometime soon?
Am I settling down? Is anybody hearing? I'm looking for a boy, actually, you know, through this TV. If I could just go out, check a few guys there and then come back inside the TV. And then if I'm impressed with somebody, then maybe I'll settle down. See, I'm a very self-confident woman, like you can see. And I don't find the need of, you know, I respect men a lot. I'm a feminist, but still I respect men a lot. I have immense respect for them. I think men are caring and they're wonderful people. But right now I'm not in that phase or space where I'm looking at settling down at all.
All right.
But if there's somebody very handsome suddenly there, very good looking and a great package, then yeah. And you can love me like immensely, that's all I need. I'll take care of you. You don't have to take care of me. You just have to love me and love me.
That's all that is there in the package?
Yeah.
Just love?
Yeah, I need lots of love, and I need him to be very dignified and respected. That's it.
That's all you have that she wants from her man. But then that's going to happen very soon, or sometime in the future. So thank you, Sanjana, for being on our show.
Thanks.
We wish you all the best for your future projects. Thank you, viewers, for watching Celeb Talk with Arfa Siddiqui. We'll see you with the next episode.